派平民的暴行不可接受。美国以各种理由为凶手开脱，使其免受惩罚的行为更令人无法容忍。当美方在领导人民主峰会上大谈民主人权的时候，那些死于美军枪口下的阿富汗无辜民众却没有人过问，他们家人的冤屈却无处申诉。这就是美国鼓吹的民主人权带给世界的残酷现实。我们谴责美方打着民主人权旗号对阿富汗、伊拉克、叙利亚等国发动军事干涉的野蛮行径。我们呼吁国际社会对美军在世界各地滥杀无辜平民的战争罪行进行调查追责。正义或许会迟到，但不会缺席。美国以所谓民主人权为借口在世界上恣意妄为的时代已经结束。
You know, it's really, I'm surprised that guy didn't burst into flames while he was saying that.
I feel like a little bit like a threat. It is?
Yeah. Yeah.
They say that they will be accountable of their act, we will not deny it. I was like, it's a threat. It's a direct threat.
Again, with the hypocrisy, though, China has basically taken over and squashed democracy in Hong Kong while the world sat on its hands. They're likely going to do the same thing to Taiwan. They insist on Taiwan being referred to as part of Greater China, against the will of the people there. They censored the internet in Hong Kong. They censored the right to protest in Hong Kong. And to hear this guy prattle on about human rights is a little bit much. And then we've got Uyghurs and Christians inside China. 1 million religious and ethnic minorities are in concentration camps right now. They're getting their Muslim and Christian names removed so that they have Chinese names. The Chinese state government is rewriting the Bible. Any verses that refer to the supremacy of God above the government are being removed. They are stopping ethnic Uyghurs from speaking their own language in the interest of, I guess, oh, I don't know what the right word is, turning them into Sinophiles, you know, lovers of the Chinese state. They had two Canadians imprisoned for, I think, nearly 2 years. Mm-hmm. And then we've got a Canadian citizen, a Uyghur Canadian citizen. He's a Uyghur activist. As best I can tell, he's never actually, this is the concentration camps, by the way. Oh. But as best I can tell, this Canadian citizen has never done anything wrong except to be Uyghur. And I think he's going on 13 years in prison there, just for being an activist for his people. These concentration camps are making items for the Western world. I'm looking at you, Nike. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to hear this Chinese state mouthpiece talk about human rights, give me a break. They are one of the largest scale, most organized violators of human rights in the entire world, and they are as imperialist as ever.
Yeah, they are actually the... China is the country where the people have the less rights, I think, in the world.
Yeah.
So it's, and now they are judging like USA. Do they are doing that because their Olympic have been like boycotted by North America, most of it? Maybe it's just like revenge. They just want to maybe. Like, for all the world that happened in the world, now you choose them, this moment now, to send a direct threat.
Yeah.
That's
yeah, special. I mean, I think it is directly related to the fact that North America has... here it is. The practice of sport is a human right. So is the practice of religion, my good Chinese mouthpiece. And yet you don't allow Christians or Uyghurs to practice their religion or the Falun Gong. That's another religious minority in China whose bodies, by the way, are routinely parted out like a used car and their organs are sold to the highest bidder or just harvested for transplant into Chinese communist leaders who need an organ. They they harvest the organs from the religious minority Falun Gong. And this guy is prattling on about how sport is a human right. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't, but religious practice definitely is, and not imprisoning ethnic minorities. You know, I'm not taking any advice from this guy. But yeah, this is the Chinese state being deeply embarrassed because North American diplomats are boycotting the Olympics, and not even the athletes, just the diplomats. And this guy's feelings are hurt.
Yeah, and some of the people call it like the genocide Olympics.
Yeah, it is.
2022.
Yeah, this is like Hitler's Olympics. Yeah.
Yeah. It's crazy. I like the intensity of hate that we live on right now. It's unbelievable. Like, I have the impression that people begin to just hate. Just hate. What will happen in a couple of months if that hate just rise and more, just we should be united, and now we are divided.
Yeah, and we should be marginalizing China. You know, this is one of the things that I think Donald Trump was really good at. He wanted to repatriate American manufacturing. He said, why are we manufacturing in China when American workers can do it? All we're doing is enriching China and making them more powerful so that they can do things like threaten us because of the Olympic boycott and take over Hong Kong and threaten Taiwan and dictate what happens at the UN climate change conferences or any sort of UN thing. They're the most powerful guys in the room, especially now that Joe Biden's in charge. Donald Trump was so right on this. We had to starve the dragon of its economic power, and we should be marginalizing them, doing as little business as possible with them. Unfortunately, our leaders just don't have the will. Oh, hi. That was a clip from our Rebel Daily live stream. It's hosted Monday, Wednesday, and Friday by the big boss man, Ezra Levant, and Tuesdays and Thursdays by me, Sheila Gunn-Reed, and my good friend, David Menzies. On the live stream, we talk about the news of the day, we show some videos, and we interact with our viewers at home. We stream at 12 noon Eastern, 10 Mountain. You can find us on YouTube, Rumble, Super U, and Odyssey.